Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to your Survivor Series 2015 live reactions. Apparently, there was a match on the pre-show. I don't watch the pre-show, so frankly, I don't care. I have heard that it was a 5-on-5 match where it ended up being the four babyfaces beating all five heels. So I don't regret not live reacting to that. How about you, John?
I don't regret it either. I'm really not regretting much right now.
Did you actually manage to watch the match? Because I didn't even turn the pre-show on while that was happening.
I mean, I did. It was a collection of misfits on both the babyface and the heel side.
Was it a collection of misfits?
Oh God, Miz was a part of the heel team, and I think that pun. I'm torn between giggling and getting cancer. But yeah, babyface team won. And the only elimination for the babyfaces, the only loss they suffered, was Neville. Freaking Neville. You know who else is on that team that didn't get eliminated? Titus O'Neil.
Wow. Rethink on that team.
Oh, my God. Let me think. Dudley's, and Goldust.
And Goldust.
Yeah. So, rethink your priorities, people.
So, you know, the guy that matters most, the guy that has the biggest future, the guy that's going to make you the most money in the long term, is the only one on that team that ate a pinfall, or was it a submission?
It was a pinfall. He got hit with a running Bo Dog and then a skull-crushing finale by Miz, who stole the tag from Bo. So it was a concerted effort. So they were probably thinking, well, this will keep Neville looking strong. Not when Titus O'Neil is still standing on the apron. And just in case, no, because I just want to get this out of my system before we start talking about this fest of Alberto Del Bitchbag versus Roman Reigns. Yeah, in case any of you still had any optimism thinking, well, there's still good in the world, you know, and I still believe Cesaro is probably going to be out for 4 to 6 months with a torn rotator cuff, so Merry freaking Christmas, people. Happy Birthmas.
Happy Birthmas.
Yeah, that's right. Whatever birthday that any of you are having right now at Survivor Series, combine that with Christmas, because it's just one giant torrent of shit.
I hope you feel better.
I really don't, because we're dealing with this sellout bitch bag in Del Rio in the semifinals against Roman Reigns, and we just know. I think I'm only going to enjoy this match because Roman is going to kick Del Rio's ass, so, yeah.
Yeah, that's definitely the point of this match happening, John.
Exactly. Garnering that babyface heat.
I don't think that's the right word, but
You know what? It doesn't matter.
I said I was going with it, okay?
They're good.
Don't you sass me, mister.
I'm sassing
everyone.
I'm
not in the mood.
No prisoners. I may even take off my shirt. I haven't decided yet.
Wow, you have a shirt on?
Damn right I do.
That makes one of us.
And depending on how long that is entirely up to you, dear viewer. If I get weird, will you stick around? You may just have to find out.
Oh, of course they will. They love us.
Indeed you do, and we thank you for that, no matter how irrational that love may be at times.
Yeah, because this live reactions is about to get all kinds of weird.
It hasn't already. I mean, you know, we're definitely going to cross the threshold before the night is through, trust me.
Yeah, I mean, after all, as if the fact that it happened wasn't enough, now we're getting to see this pay-per-view, which, I mean, obviously we're super looking forward to. Guess where it is, though, John? It's in Atlanta, because something devastating didn't already happen earlier today in the city.
Exactly.
Goddamn Falcons.
Way to give it away, Falcons! You had one job!
They were up 14 and... No, they were up 14 points. 21-7.
And, you know, I find it just perfect, Ashton, that on the same day that Devontae Freeman came down with a concussion, because you know how much you and I both love him.
Cesaro comes down with a torn rotator cuff.
Exactly. You know, it's just pile it on.
The two only good things in our lives.
I'll tell you, if the world fed people through misery, there would be no world hunger, people. Because you get ample amounts.
That's the truest thing I think I've ever heard. And what's really great is that the super rich would starve so quickly.
I know, right? Because they're never happy despite their excessive opulence. Disgusting. That's right, Del Rio. Work over the arm. And that's right, Roman. Power through it anyway. Nobody give a shit about anything. Just have the match. Do it.
I can't wait for later on tonight when Paige will work over Charlotte's arms, legs, and torso for a half hour only for her to lock in the figure eight like it's nothing.
Oh, yeah. Damn right, brother. And I can't wait for Cesaro, for Kevin Owens, rather, because Cesaro ain't gonna be on this card, not after the shit we've heard. I can't wait for Kevin Owens to beat Dean Ambrose, and then beat Roman Reigns, and then unify the championships the same way he unifies the family on Family Game Night, because he's a father! Damn it! Sorry, I just didn't know any other way I was gonna get that line in, because I fully expect Dean Ambrose to go over, and as you can see, this live reaction is abiding by no rules whatsoever, as Del Rio's still in control.
And there's the enziguri.
Oh man, you know what though? Del Rio's presence in WWE actually does have an inadvertent effect that is a positive. It makes me look that much more forward to Lucha Underground Season 2, knowing full well he's not going to be on the product.
Right, though?
And
It's gonna be so much better for not having him in it.
knowing full well that it was Johnny Mundo that sent him packing kayfabe-wise.
Yes.
Suck those nuts, bitch bag!
As far as the Lucha Underground universe goes, Johnny Mundo retired Alberto El Patron.
Yeah, that's right, which means, in a weird way, Johnny Mundo's kind of the arbiter of who stays and who goes. I
Well,
like that
I
power.
mean, Drago kind of also retired Hernandez, so they have a match there.
Well, I guess Drago and Mundo will have to have a match, and
How
no.
did we not mention that? Johnny Mundo versus Drago is a match I would love to see.
Yeah, I'd love to see Mundo just use his parkour strength to just crush Drago's skull and drain his power. There can only be one.
I thought you were going to say drain his blood. I was about to think it was getting weird.
Well, I mean that too, obviously. Power's an all-encompassing thing, you know.
Speaking of power, let's talk about how powerful this rest hold is.
It! Work the rest hold! Go for 10 minutes straight non-stop. Keep talking to each other about how the last 5 minutes of the match is gonna go for 10 minutes. Do it! I know you have the balls!
I mean, this is Alberto Del Rio we're talking about. I don't know if I would really compliment him on having balls.
That's so true, cause he cut and ran at the first sight of good money being thrown his way.
The hilarious thing is, I just love it too, because you can just tell from the way he works his matches that he is miserable there too.
Well, yeah, like, and that's the thing, Ashton. You could tell towards the tail end of his first run, right, that his matches seemed to me so dispirited. I saw some people, and again, this isn't me trying to stack the deck. Everybody knows that you and I are huge Lucha Underground fans, but I legitimately saw people say that they thought it was a shame that Del Rio left because they thought some of the best work of his career was happening in Lucha Underground. I mean, that TV match he had with Johnny Mundo was fantastic, and don't get me wrong, I thoroughly loved their Ultimate Lucha match, but that match they had on TV, I thought was fantastic, and I'm like, man, it's great to see Del Rio actually look passionate and this and that, and then the scumbag does this. So, you know
And now
what?
he's back to putting on phoned-in three-star matches with randoms.
Exactly. So, good job there, Birdie. Good job there.
Good job there, Bertie.
Let me steal your car and commit vandalism, even though I'm the baby face. My
Oh,
God,
Sheamus. He
where
had
the
to
hell
wait.
are we?
Sheamus knew what he wanted out of the world.
Yeah, he did. You know what? You have to commend a man for that. Like, he braided his facial hair. He's got this great Celtic-inspired look, and he carries it with swagger. He's like, I ain't even mad. I ain't even mad. Come at me with your jeers. I'm money in the bank, baby. What are you? And you know what? Yeah. Good on Sheamus, people. Good on Sheamus.
I actually really like Sheamus too.
I know. I wish
Just as long
WWE.
as he's not working against Randy Orton.
Exactly. Oh, is it gonna be the spear? No, the clothesline, of course, because we have to drag it out. But I wish WWE liked Sheamus as much as you and I like Sheamus, because man, every Money in the Bank holder always has this period of stagnation before cashing in.
They're gonna love Sheamus come next year in the spring.
Right. But you know, it's always so frustrating with certain talents how WWE seems to love people at the wrong time. Because when Sheamus first came back and stuff, I thought he was one of the more interesting heels and had more momentum than some other heels like on the roster. And you know, now considering this dearth of talent that we're suffering from, it'd be really nice if Sheamus was looking more legitimate than he does right now.
Oh, he stroked his fist!
He did. It's coming. It's coming.
Well, that was inappropriate language to use.
Well, I mean, I just thought we'd build on the euphemism. I thought you started it, and then you were passing it on to me. I'm sorry, I fumbled it. Okay? I'm sorry.
I mean, I was at least trying to keep it subtle.
Well, there was nothing subtle about that backstabber and the subsequent nearfall.
It's called a lung blower.
Oh, it's called whatever we want to call it. And now Del Rio picking up Roman by that vest. That's yeah. Another thing, too. You'd have to think if Roman did turn heel by, you know, some miracle tonight, that he would also change the attire finally. And you'd think, like, wow, he'd finally get, like, his own inspired gear. Maybe, like, what he was wearing in NXT or something.
Yeah, maybe he would actually, you know, dress like a wrestler.
Instead of extra security. It's like, I'm a security guard and wrestler. Yeah, exactly.
That's the name of his theme song.
I'm just, you know, a private contractor, but in my off time, I like to wrestle. You know, no big deal. And Del Rio.
Oh, Del Rio's setting up for the super kick to the neat opponent.
Telegraph it. Telegraph it so hard. Look at him working that arm. He's like, yeah, it's coming.
What?
And, what the hell even was what?
I think that Reigns missed his cue to, like, get out of the way, and Del Rio just, like, swung wildly with his foot and missed
it. Well, at least he recovered with the Samoan drop, so as to say, that botch just now, it's irrelevant.
Dude, you keep on making Roman Reigns seem like a heel, but after tonight, we're going to have to, like, I don't even know, because he's going to be a face champion.
Swallow his era as a babyface for the next decade like a shard of glass that just cuts you on the way down. Some other people's language, not necessarily mine.
I'm sorry, did you say something about Roman Reigns and a decade? Because I yawned.
That communicates that he's bored.
Actually, it communicates that I've slept a grand total of about 16 hours in the last 3 nights, but that works for communicating a point.
Dude, you're breaking the fourth wall. No, Roman Reigns going for that superplex.
Suck a fat one.
Yes. And on this day,
we're gonna get the double stomp off the Tree of Woe.
And it's only gonna get a near fall because Roman Reigns isn't like those other scrubs that got beat by it.
Yeah, exactly. Except he's not even gonna hit it.
Oh, wow,
he
broke
his fist again.
He's gonna do it now. He's gonna
punch.
He's got it that time.
He strokes his fist twice. That makes it extra hard.
Oh, my God. Euphemism overload. His range is pumped up. Oh, man. Here it comes. The big finish.
A spear.
Roman, wow, you're really stalking it, Roman. Oh, Del Rio could actually be feigning a lot. That would be genius. If he's just like, oh, no, I can't continue. I'm hurt. And then he gets Roman in a small package.
Ooh!
So you're actually going to get
up. What a super kick.
Wow.
One, two! And Reigns kicks out.
Wow.
Drama, John!
Yeah, of course, right? Because you need some dramatic effect with the idea that Roman Reigns might lose this match. Unbelievable.
I just saw a Mix America sign in the crowd.
Oh my God. Of course people would buy into it.
You have no idea how many posts I've seen over the last month. People on Reddit asking, how is Alberto Del Rio a heel? He wants to unite two countries and be the king.
And be a king you threw in there.
Well, yeah, that wasn't actually a part of the question.
Oh, man. Oh, that's right. Call for that armbar, even though it feels like it's been several minutes since you've even worked over the arm. Oh, you're all over the place, Berto.
Armbar.
Oh, my goodness.
Boom. Sit-out style, like his predecessor, Batista. Oh, my God. I thought that was actually going to get him the three count. I mean, we know he's going to win. We just don't know how. I mean, I guess we do know how. I'm just hoping that they change things up. But I shouldn't be so delusional. He's gonna win.
I know, what the hell's wrong with you, man?
It's Roman Reigns. It's paint by numbers, John. Come on, I need to realize this.
I mean, I, for one, though, am shocked by the power of Roman Reigns. Who would have thought that he could have such heart, such will to win?
I know. Name one person that can lift somebody up with nothing but their, and of course the other person's, abdominal muscles combined.
I can't think of a single person, man. It's unbelievable.
Would you say it's unbelievable?
You know what? I would. I would say that, actually. Oh, man. Am I the only one? Oh wow!
Earthbreaker!
Oh wow! Look at that. Okay, that was kind of a cool spot. I like that he
Implying
said he
Roman
got the
Reigns
Thunder.
will ever tap to anyone ever. See, the WWE knows they got it wrong with John Cena because he tapped out to Chris Benoit, Kurt Angle, and Chris Jericho early in his career. They're actually going to be able to say that Roman Reigns has never tapped ever.
Exactly. Is Del Rio still keeping it locked? Oh, he is, but he's got to break it.
Wow, that actually looked painful.
It
Oh, Del Rio's about to do a flying nothing! Yes!
did. Get caught with a spear. Oh, actually, no,
There
he was for a
it
second.
is!
And, yep, on the
One,
rebound, baby.
two, three, and it's over.
Oh, man. By the power of nepotism.
I love it when Del Rio does his flying nothing. He does it better than anyone.
Yeah, I'll agree with you there. And
Coming off that top rope, swinging your arms wildly at nothing.
I just punched zero in my calculator, and I've determined that this result came into the surprise of absolutely no one. Oh, man.
Well, I mean, you don't really need a calculator if you're giving the calculator the answer before you ask it for the answer.
Look, man, I just want to be sure, you know? I'm a thorough kind of guy.
You and your philosophical ways, making sure zero still equals zero.
As we see here, I
What
love the
is reality, John?
I'm actually trying to figure that out, but what doesn't take much figuring out is that Roman Reigns is the worst pain face ever. His mouth is all open like, "Oh, I'm pretending this hurts. Oh God, all my hair's out of place." But actually, this did look legitimately painful to Ashton's point, guys, when he's just almost had like a piece of the arm and he's hanging on and he's just kind of having all that weight on it.
That flying nothing, though, that was gorgeous.
And then the spear! And Zeb Coulter is probably twirling his mustache or whatever he's got going on with extra anger. So.
Yeah, I was gonna say, doesn't he usually twirl the mustache when his team wins so that he can just like do it out of pride?
Wins when he's in a state of contemplation about what advice to give his team. You know, I just think his hand naturally gravitates to, you know, his facial hair. So.
Yeah, maybe. There it is. Let's get that Roman lit up.
Yeah, buddy.
Numerous Romans.
Oh man.
Who's going to win between Owens and Ambrose? This one I honestly think is a toss-up because if they really want to go hardcore like Roman Reigns face mode, they'll have Owens beat Ambrose and then leave Reigns.
See, now let me ask you something, Ashton, because we agree already that nobody's turning heel, so I'm just assuming that that answer applies here. But I've also thought about the very slim possibility that Owens does win, right? But Ambrose being so jaded, he screws Roman Reigns anyway, thus giving Owens the win. I mean, what do you think? I don't think it's going to happen, but it is something that crossed my mind.
Yeah, I doubt it. I don't necessarily think that Owens winning is out of the picture, but I do think that if he does, I don't know why Ambrose would get involved.
Right.
Wow, Jerry, talk about an ego. Do you see Lawler's shirt? It literally says King Lawler on it.
Wow, way to be a mark for yourself, Jerry.
And I can even tell you what the name of the font is that that lettering is done in.
Yeah, because Ashton is a beast when it comes to typography, so.
It's called Scriptina, and it's my favorite cursive font. It's so good.
So how does it feel seeing your favorite cursive font on a shirt that horrid? Does it hurt you?
Well, I mean, we already established that Jerry Lawler has a massive ego, so obviously he wanted the best.
It's just so basic, though.
Well, yeah, but it's also Scriptina, so I mean, what more do you really need?
I just feel a disconnect with you right now. But regardless, I'm assuming that I don't know if they're going to do Owens and Ambrose later tonight, or if that's the matchup that we're going to have next.
No, yeah, it's probably gonna be next.
Yeah, just get that out. Oh, it's
JoJo!
JoJo!
Yeah!
Something good on this show. How wonderful.
That bun is powerful. That thing's as big as her head.
I like it. I think she pulls it off.
Seriously, look at the size of that bun.
Oh, Dean Ambrose!
Hey, Dino!
Oh, look at Roman Reigns foreshadowing.
What do you mean?
Well, he said, once you do the same with Kevin Owens, it's going to be me and you for the championship later tonight.
Oh, I always thought foreshadowing was more subtle than that.
Yeah, it's pretty explicit. Pretty like, hey guys, the main event may actually be interesting, although neither one of us is turning.
Yeah, that wasn't so much foreshadowing as it was just spoiling.
Somebody get Paul Heyman in here.
Yeah. Oh, there's Owens. Yes.
Oh my god, he's so much better than everyone else.
He's interesting, unlike everyone else.
Exactly. The only thing that really gives me faith in humanity, Kevin Owens.
All right, people. Well, I mean, the match has been over for a long time, and I think we've gotten enough of our salt out that I can end this recording. So that was our first match of the night. Roman Reigns.